Well, good morning. Good morning and welcome to Unity of Kent Sunday Service for August 6th, 2023. My name is Reverend Patty Becker and I'm delighted to be here with you today. Welcome all of you on Zoom as well as those in the sanctuary. We're blessed today with our musician, Sammy Barnard, and I was listening to his practice a few minutes ago and I love his song selections, so I hope you enjoy it too. Our worship assistant this morning is Linnell Mooney. And so, Sammy, would you please grace us with your opening song?
Certainly.
Certainly.
Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you want to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come. One day every tongue will confess you are God. And one day every knee will bow. And still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. But still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now.
Oh, good to see you.
Come. Now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come. Now that every tongue will confess you are God. Now that every knee can bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. One day every tongue will confess you are God. And one day every knee will bow. And still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come. Come, come, come.
Thank you, Sammy. Thank you, that's great. Well, good morning again. I apologize for smudging up your song by taking off. I did a little bit. It was just a spontaneous thing. I completely forgot where I was in the it's all good now. Thank you. Welcome to this Sunday service, and I'm so happy to be here and have you with here too with me. Today is our first Sunday of the month, and it is the Silent Unity Prayer Service, so this is a meditation Sunday. So I hope you find it infilling and can give yourself over to that process of deepening and awareness as well as relaxation. Unity, and especially Unity of Kent, is a welcoming community. We invite people of all races, creeds, colors, lifestyles, political persuasions, abilities to be with us, to enjoy and enter into this community in which Your spirituality and your spiritual authority is respected and encouraged, that our teachings are based on those of Jesus as well as New Thought principles. We interpret the Bible and things that happen in our daily lives through the lens of metaphysics. And metaphysics is being able to look at our physical surroundings, our physical circumstances and situations, to be able to glean the deeper meaning or the deeper call behind each one of those situations. And doing that in my personal life has been very enriching and has provided a foundation and a platform of growth and expansion in consciousness. That has been very, very helpful on a day-to-day basis. So as Sammy opened our service with a very invitational song, I would like to open with prayer. So those of you here and those of you on Zoom, if we just, I invite you to close your eyes if that is more comfortable for you, simply to focus your attention away from outside stimuli and into your being, into your heart, and into your soul. Our statement of faith, as well as our belief, is that there is one presence and one power active in the universe and active in our lives, that this presence and power is impartial. It is love, it is life, it is expansive. This presence and power is the guiding force of all of our lives, providing for each one of us an opportunity to enter into a growth process which is dedicated to our good. And though spirit and omnipotence is its will is for our good, it is up to us to cooperate with that good by aligning ourselves with the goodness that is God, or this power of the universe, which we may call by whatever name is most meaningful to us. And so today, here in this moment, we are present with that desire in us to open and to grow in spirit. We condition our hearts to be receptive to inspiration through the music, through the word, through our meditation and prayer, through our community of being with one another, of celebrating one another, and encouraging one another, of sharing our light and our life with the whole community. And so to this end, let us be dedicated during our service this day, and to know that God is good all the time, in all ways. And so it is. Amen.
I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am. Whatever I do, wherever I go, whoever I think I am. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am. Wherever I go, whatever I do, whoever I think I am. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God. I am sustained by the love of God, by the love of God.
Thank you, Sammy. That I am sustained by the love of God. For those of you who are Course in Miracles fans, that would be the one statement that would jump out to you in one of the workbook lessons, and it has for me. My name is Linnell Mooney. I'm your worship assistant today, so welcome. I welcome those on Zoom and Facebook too, and I would hope that you would join us all in our statement of faith. Let us begin that. There is one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, God the good, omnipotent. I trust and align with that power of goodness now. All right. Those of you, if you take a look in your bulletin, you'll find a goldenrod colored prayer slip. I'm seeking mine right now. Oh, well, I know it's on here. Here we are. We're going to collect these in just a moment, so if you want to take the time to fill it in, and we'll collect those for our blessing of our prayers. For those of you on Zoom, I'll give you an opportunity to unmute and say your prayers out loud. All right. We have some announcements today. First off, Spirit Talk still continues on Wednesday mornings on Zoom at 10 a.m., If you'd like to join that lively discussion on Wednesdays, you can go to our website, go to the events page, find Spirit Talk for Wednesday mornings at 10 o'clock. Our Quest class is still continuing. We're over halfway through the year, and it is not a closed class. You can join at any time. Come and join us. We have wonderful discussions about the Quest books that we've been reading through. And that begins at 6:30 on Tuesday nights. Again, you can go to the website, find that Zoom link, and join us. We have no hospitality today, and not because of someone got lazy and forgot. It's because we have Keeping Connected today, which is a very important meeting. So those of you who are joining us for service, please remain on Zoom and join us directly after the service for Keeping Connected. This is where we'll be discussing our future here at Unity Acant. Okay, I am sustained by the love of God. Let us begin with our virtues today. If you'll see in your bulletin, you can join me for the affirmation. Neighborly is our virtue. Having or showing qualities that demonstrate friendliness, generosity, or helpfulness towards one's fellow human beings. Being concerned for those living nearby and acting on behalf of their well-being. An attitude of inclusion and willingness to reach out to others. Let's affirm that together. I am neighborly. I am sincere in my concern for others. I reach out to others in a spirit of friendship. I am inclusive. Wonderful. Today's daily word for Sunday, August 6th, is faith. No matter my need, I begin with faith. In the story of Unity, James Dillett Freeman tells a story from the Unity's movement early days. During a period of financial insufficiency, staff gathered together to pray. An associate said, "Let us pray that the money holds out." Co-founder Myrtle Fillmore countered, "Oh no, let us pray that our faith holds out." Today I remember the importance of faith in all my endeavors. Like everyone, I will need all kinds of things during my lifetime. More money, more time, greater harmony, to name a few. Rather than pray for specific things or results, praying for the understanding and clarity to draw upon my faith is the best place to begin. I believe in the absolute goodness of God, and I believe in myself as a spiritual being endowed with the gift of faith to direct however I choose. And in Mark chapter 9, verse 23, all things can be done for the one who believes. All right, let's go ahead and grab those prayer slips. And Barbara will come around and collect them. Just hold them out so she can pick them up. Those of you on Zoom, would you please unmute at this time if you wish to say your prayer out loud?
All right. So no one on Zoom has a prayer request to share? All right. Oh, yes.
I'd like to
have prayers for Camille. Okay,
prayers for Camille.
Lost a partner? Unexpectedly. So prayers for Camille. Anyone else in the congregation? I'd like to pray for myself. I would like to ask for prayers for me in this coming weeks. There's several people close to me who are experiencing serious health issues, and a few are approaching transition. So for my own peace of mind and strength and ability to be present not only with these friends and families, but also be present with myself in the present moment of where I find myself. So I would ask that of you. All right, so it's our custom that we rub our hands together and extend our energy towards our prayer box. And our statement of faith begins with, "There's one presence and one power active in the universe, active in my life," and I would add, active in the lives of our loved ones. This presence and power, we affirm, is absolute good. This presence and power does not struggle with an adversary, but it is complete and potent in and of itself. This presence and power is the very foundation of our own souls, of our own beingness. And the gifts of this presence and power are our 12 faculties of love, of life, of wisdom, of will, of all of the things that are altruistic and that move us forward into greater consciousness. We know for every challenge there is a comfort and a solution. And it is not up to us. What we are asked to do is to align ourselves with the presence and power we call God, or any other name that is meaningful to us. And to know that beyond my human solutions, beyond my human understanding, there is a divine will and law that is unfolding for the highest and best. And so I echo our daily word. faith, having complete and perfect faith in the invisible workings of spiritual alignment in my life and the lives of those I love and care about, and within every situation and circumstance which may cause us to be concerned or worried, the faith knows underlying each of these occasions there is a power and a plan that must move towards the good of all, beyond chaos, beyond disharmony. There is perfect peace and perfect outcome. And so it is. Amen.
All right, it's time for handshakes and hugs and namaste. Go ahead and greet your friends.
All right. I'm so glad.
I'm just getting over a cold, so I'm not really sure I should be hugging.
Okay. Kurt.
I'm just getting over a cold. So
oh, okay.
Don't get too cold.
Okay.
What? Maybe I broke it in yesterday.
Weave and weave us together, weave us together, together in love. Weave us together, weave us together, together in love. Weave us together, weave us together in unity and love. Weave us together, weave us together, together in love. Weave us together. Weave us together, weave and weave us together, weave us together, together in love. When I pray, I feel my heart go deeper, my heart go deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my heart go deeper, my heart goes deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. When I pray, I feel my soul go deeper, my soul goes deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my soul go deeper. My soul goes deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. When I pray, I feel the love go deeper. My love goes deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my love go deeper. My love go deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. And right here, right now, right where I am, I pray.
Thank you, Sam. Yes. When we pray, we go deeper, our heart expands, we come into relationship, into the territory of spirit. And that's exactly what this service is today, this first Sunday of the month, and every first Sunday of the month service, dedicated to meditation and to prayer. Today I'll be facilitating the Unity Prayer Service, monthly prayer service, for August. Prayer is such a foundation, for our spiritual lives. It's how we deepen. It's how we become more available to the gifts that we have, to the strengths and to the helps that we have to manage our daily lives in which there seems to be chaos or challenges or things that go sideways. Prayer is a way in which we build up our spiritual muscle and resilience so that we might always be with ourselves, so we are in our true natures, which is spiritual natures. Sometimes saying being in our spiritual nature is misleading or kind of confusing, and the question might come up, well, what is my spiritual nature? Does that mean just when I'm sitting down and praying or when I'm sitting down and meditating? And I don't think so. I think our spiritual natures are active and vibrant at all periods of our lives within all situations, and it's an attitude. It's an attitude with which we meet our challenges, with which we enter into chaos, or in which we frame our experiences. It's a way of being that accesses our internal resilience, our internal wisdom, our internal peace, and our internal strength. And we have all of those things. All of those things that we label the 12 powers don't float in and out of our lives and come up just when we need them. They are always present as the nature, the foundation, the absolute truth of who we actually are as a spiritual being. Now we have other things, other realities that we maneuver through, and that is a part of our physical life, these situations that come up, circumstances that we experience. That's the physical frame around our spiritual being. And as we deepen our spiritual awareness, we can maneuver our physical experience in much more peaceful ways, in ways that become strengths for us instead of diminishments. And the way we strengthen that awareness is through prayer and meditation. And I would say is through awareness and how we direct our attention when we are in these circumstances that are challenging. In terms of prayer, I think there's also a misunderstanding. I know I have experienced this in my prayer life many times, in which my erroneous thought was, if I pray extra hard, if I focus extra attention, and I can just feel that tension coming up of being really, really fervent, that if I'm serious enough and if I'm fervent enough, then I'll catch the ear of God and it will come, and circumstances will right themselves. And so I took that emotion on to myself, being really focused, really emotional. And I think in reality what I was doing is I was narrowing the conduit through which grace flows. I had an idea in my mind, and I put so much obvious attention and focus on the outcome that I wanted that I missed the boat in imagining or opening up a conduit through which Spirit could work for me. So I took on extra work when I didn't have to. I think what is more to the truth in prayer and meditation is not the degree of intensity with which we approach it, but the degree of relaxation with which we encounter prayer and meditation, in which we encounter the daily occurrences of our lives. And so it's not what we say or how emotionally we can get worked up in saying it. Rather, it is relaxing into alignment. Relaxing into alignment requires faith. And so it's a growth of our faith muscle, the growth of our faith awareness, of our realization that we are not separate from Spirit, that we are one with Spirit, and nothing in our physical lives except our thoughts about it can separate us, because it is who we are. It's like the blood in our bodies. You can't separate out the blood from our bodies. It's part of our flesh. It's part of who we are as physical beings. We can't take it out as a separate item. Now, I know there's instances where it is taken out as a separate item, but in the body as a whole, it is what is the cohesive thing that is inside our tissues, that nourishes, that cleanses, that keeps our vitality up, that provides us the conduit through which healing and vitality flows. And it's the same with prayer. In our physical lives, that prayer is the spiritual blood of our physical reality. That our spiritual reality cannot be separated out from our spiritual beingness. Only our thinking about it can alter that. Alignment is an awareness of oneness with Source. It's an awareness of oneness with Source. We are never separated from Source. But sometimes we lose awareness of our connection with Source. We lose connection that Source is the blood within us, always present, always nourishing, always active. And so alignment, spiritual alignment, is awareness of oneness with Source. And when we are in alignment with Source, paradoxically, it removes all need to pray for anything. It removes all need to pray for any change or anything that you need, because when we are aware of our oneness in Source, we are constantly in touch with what is already there and what all that we need to sustain our well-being, both spiritually and physically. Source is already sourcing everything fully, and our job is to align with that Source rather than trying to get some presence and power outside of us to align with us. So our job is to align with Source, not to beg Source to be in alignment with us. And part of prayer and meditation is to help to grow that awareness and alignment. One of the key factors in being able to establish that awareness and to maintain that awareness is relaxation. It's to not to be stressed, not to be so emotionally tied up in outcome that we reduce the arena of possibilities which are already there wanting to come into fruition. And so we relax. And as we begin the Silent Unity Prayer Service, which is a series of affirmations of truth, that and also allowing it conditions the mind to be in alignment with that truth within us. And so it begins with an opportunity, an exercise of relaxation. And so that's what I'm going to start with today. One of the ways in which, I've already said this morning already, but one of the ways in which I find myself to be more fully aware of my inner state is by closing my eyes. And I invite you to do that too, if that feels comfortable for you. By closing my eyes, I reduce the opportunity of other things to take my attention away. In essence, I am removing myself from the sensual engagement with the three-dimensional physical life. And as I focus my attention inward, I'm entering the realm of the fourth dimension of all possibility, of limitlessness. When I close my eyes, behind my eyelids, I don't see borders. I don't see distinctions. I don't see limitation of any kind. It's an open field. And I call this open field spiritual possibility. Spiritual reality. A spiritual reality imbued with all possibility of engagement. Relaxation is also facilitated not only by removing physical stimulation, but also by the breath. That in and out movement that nourishes and heals. In Hebrew, breath is ruah, spirit. It means spirit. Breath, ruah. And as our breath moves in and out of our body in our natural rhythm of inhale and exhale, We are doing several things that increases our ability to grow awareness. So if you find yourself slouching and limiting the intake of breath, I invite you to be a little taller in your chair so that you open up more lung space. That you inhale fully and that you exhale fully. That let each breath be mindful and unhurried. As breath comes in, it nourishes our blood with oxygen. Oxygen to our brains, increase our awareness and our cognitive abilities, increases our thinking, increases our access to wisdom and intuition, because we're more alert, we're more able to discern. Breathing in and breathing out. And as you find your pace, your rhythm, to be aware of your body and any place in your body where you might be holding tension, any tight muscle, any contractive sensation, and to say to this part, peace, be still. Peace, relax. Let the chair, trust the chair to hold you, to support you in every way physically, so that there's no place in your body, no muscle group that has to help. As I relax, often I can feel my shoulders drop. Be still. Be still and know that I am made in the image and likeness of God. We say, be still and know that I am Godness, that I am God, that I am one with the presence, power, wisdom, life, and love of the universe. I am that from which I have come forth. As I have come forth from God, I am God. And that realization is exceptionally humbling and powerful at the same time. As we know God, we know our own true nature, which is wisdom, love, order, life, health, wholeness. As we know more and more of our true nature, we are more at peace, more in alignment with our source. And in this alignment, I affirm, with God as my peace, I rest deeply and breathe easily, quieting my thoughts and becoming still and simply be. I am present in this moment, recognizing God as the central presence and power within my being. I recognize God as the central presence and power within my being, and in this awareness, I relax, rest, and enter into the deep peace within me. And relaxing into this peace, I realize that I am peace. And so I take this awareness of peace and rest for a few moments in the silence. I am guided by infinite wisdom in all matters. Settling deeper into prayer, I open to the light of divine wisdom, illuminating my mind now. I am full of light, and I know that light shines upon the path ahead of me. Each step revealing the next, I walk in light and love. Thus illuminated, I realize the light being that I am, and I see myself in this aspect as a light shining brightly as I enter once again into the silence. I am one with and now fully flourish in divine life. In the stillness of this moment, I know I am one with and now display the glory of divine life. Releasing any thought that does not reflect life, I attune to the energy of life pulsing through me. I am pure vitality. I am whole. I am free. All of my bodily systems come into alignment in a harmonizing way, and I feel energized and whole as I return once again to the silence. Through wind and storm, I stand steady, knowing God is my strength. Being still and knowing I am one with God, I am strong and steady. Nothing can throw me. No trouble can break me. I know that my nature is spiritual strength and that my word is the word of calm in any storm. Being steady and resilient gives me strength and power. And I feel that strength and power in my physical body now as I return once again to the silence. I am willing to be a presence of divine love in all my relationships. My heart blooms with compassion as I meet others in love. I bless them, seeing only their divine identity. Wherever I go and whomever I meet, my heart hears a call for love and holds the sweetest desire to sow the seed of love within everyone I meet, within myself, a seed of love within any circumstance and every situation, seeds of love in all aspects of my life. And I feel that love now, filling my being as I return once again to the silence. Refreshed and renewed by repeated times in the silence, it is time now to return our focus to the physical world by placing our attention on the outside, but bringing from the inner world, my spiritual self, all of the gifts that I have entered into, that I have received by this time of resting in the silence. We return to our physical lives by focusing again on our breath. And as we do so, and we feel ourselves shifting, our attention moving from the quiet to the more active, I am aware of bringing inner peace with me and letting it be a part of the atmosphere all around us. We close this time of prayer with a deeper knowledge of God and our own divine nature, our nature of love, of wholeness, of life, of wisdom, and of peace. We are thankful, rested, and joyful in this spiritual communion with one another. And so it is. Amen.
Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers, listen to what they're saying. Seek a higher consciousness, a state of peacefulness. And know that God is always there. And every thought becomes a prayer. Our thoughts are prayers, and we are always praying. Our thoughts are prayers. Listen to what you're saying. Seek a higher consciousness, a state of peacefulness, and know that God is always there. And every thought becomes a prayer. And every thought becomes a prayer.
Thank you, Sammy. And that's so true, that our thoughts are prayers, that what we are thinking sets the blueprint of what we experience. And so that's why there's such an emphasis in unity in prayer on awareness, like there was today. Because being aware of what we are saying and how we are saying it, how we are expressing ourselves, builds our experiences. It bears out. That's the manifestation in what we think and how we feel is borne out in what we experience. And that puts, to me, that's a lot of responsibility on us, but that's a great, that's the good news, is that we are in control of ourselves in that way. And we can be the director of our minds and our thoughts and our awareness. So now is the time in our service when we collect our love offerings, when we express our faith, our daily word today, in an abundant universe, through the joyful and easy giving of our financial resources in support of our community. And as we give, we shape our consciousness as well. Notice within yourselves, as I notice within me, what it feels like to give this love offering. Is it with a joyful expectation? Is it with kind of a push-pull feeling? Is it with a sense of, I don't know, it might be a little sense of lack? But just to notice, and to notice if what you're thinking as you give serves you and serves your greater prosperity. And so we have a prosperity affirmation today. It's in your bulletin right before the offertory blessing. And today's affirmation is, every day in every way, God blesses me with prosperous divine ideas. Every day in every way, God blessed me with prosperous divine ideas. And this blessing is constant. This blessing is a continuous flow. And so let's own it together as we say this together. Every day, in every way, God bless me with prosperous divine ideas. And our offertory blessing is divine love flowing as me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I am. And Guy will come around and collect our offerings. And
God is my source, God is my power, God gives me everything I need. So I give thanks for all my blessings. God gives me everything I need. God is my source, God is my power, God gives me everything I need. So I give thanks for all my blessings. God gives me everything I need.
And so we rub our hands together again to get that energy up, and we direct that energy towards our offering. And we bless these offerings and each life from which they come. We see each one of us in this sanctuary on Zoom, each one who supports Unity of Kent in a field of prosperity and aliveness, knowing that being conduits of God's graces, that we bless not only one another and our community and support our and fulfill our financial responsibilities, but as a tithing church, we also support the larger community in giving to other areas. And so we are grateful to be part of this circle of giving and receiving, joyfully and easily, and everything I am and everything I do, and so it is. Amen. All right. Well, I've enjoyed the opportunity to be in meditation with you today. I hope it was also infilling for you. And why don't we gather in our circle, and we'll do our peace song. And I think, Sammy, you're going to be doing the... Oh, birthdays. Yes, it's birthdays. All right. That's right, August. Anyone here have an August birthday? Ah, all right. You get to be in our circle.
I've never hit it before.
Oh, okay. Leslie's birthday this month. Anyone else? Yeah, you've been? Okay. Does anyone know of an August birthday? Okay, my sister-in-law, Susan, so I'm going to put her in our circle.
My brother.
Okay, what's his name?
Jeffrey.
Okay. All right. Anyone else? August, I know. It's a hot month.
Herbert Hoover.
Herbert Hoover?
Same day as mine.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, all August birthdays. Sammy?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, you are wonderful. Happy birthday to you. God is blessing you now. God is blessing you now. God is blessing, you are wonderful. God is blessing you now.
So where's the cake?
Where's the cake? Yeah. All right, our peace song.
Oh, let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as creator, united all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my joyous vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us wherever we are. God is. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God will protect us. And the presence of God watches over us wherever we are. God is, God is, God is, God is. God is, God is, God is. God is. God is, God is.
All right. The
Don't
light
go
of.
Away.
Yeah. Well, thank you for joining us. Oh, it came back. All right. The light of God surrounds us. I am the light that is God. The love of God enfolds us. I am the love that is God. The power of God protects us. I am the power that is God. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence that is God. Wherever I am, God is, and all is well. And may all be well with you this week, and have a very blessed week ahead of you. Staying for the in about 2 minutes or 3 minutes, you on Zoom, if you stay tuned, we'll be having our Keeping Connected meeting. So you have just enough time for a little break and then come back. And we'll start that meeting up soon, okay? All right.
I am
coordinated, yeah. Kurt?